When I was a kid, my best friend and I both had remote control cars. And rather than just race them, which is boring, we decided we were going to have epic battles where we smashed them into each other until just one car was remaining. Here's the thing, in these battles, we each had our own advantage. My friend's car was a sports car. It was fast, but light. I had a pickup truck. It was slow, but very heavy. And as we collided them over and over again, we saw that the speed and the mass mattered to these collisions. Over the long run, though, we both lost as our cars were smashed to itsy bitsy bits. Anyway, this is supposed to be about physics, not my lost car. And in physics, when we're thinking about collisions and mass and velocity, we really have in mind something called momentum, which depends on mass and velocity. Let's learn all about momentum. Let's start by reviewing our lesson objectives. First, we'll explain momentum, just to kind of give you an idea for what it is. Then we'll learn to calculate momentum. And there we'll actually put a number on this idea. And lastly, we'll learn about the properties of momentum. It has several important properties that we'll actually continue to cover in future lessons, but we'll take a look at them here for the first time. First up, what in the world is momentum? Well, we can give a definition of momentum as the tendency of an object to stay in motion. The tendency of an object to stay in motion. We'll think about that definition as we go through what momentum depends on. As we mentioned in the intro, momentum depends on mass. Momentum depends on mass. So if something has high mass, like this container ship, just imagine trying to stop this, it has high momentum. And now you can see what we mean by a tendency to stay in motion. This container ship is going to keep moving unless something very serious happens. Momentum also depends on velocity. High velocity, like the velocity of this bullet, also leads to high momentum, meaning it's challenging to stop this bullet. It has a tendency to stay in motion. Now, we can calculate momentum with this equation, P equals mv. Let's go through each of these variables. First up, we have mass, which is represented by m, that makes sense, and it has to be in kilograms. That's very important. So we're going to do a few practice problems here shortly, and remember that the mass has to be in kilograms. V is velocity. Those are the two things we said impact momentum, and its unit is meters per second. What in the world could p be? Well, we know maybe by the process of elimination, it has to be momentum, and its units are going to be kilograms, meters per second. Now, I know it's a little weird to use P for momentum, but basically we've just used M all over the place, so we can't use M. And so we use P. I know it's a little strange. It comes from impulse, which has a P in it, but nonetheless, it's just a little weird, but you just have to remember P is what we use for momentum. First up, let's actually use this equation by calculating the momentum of a 25-gram bullet moving at 2,600 meters per second. Pretty fast, right? There's going to be two steps here. First up, we're going to have to convert mass to kilograms, because remember we said that mass is always in kilograms. And here we've been given the mass of the bullet in grams. And then we'll go ahead and calculate momentum. Let's go ahead and practice calculating momentum now. We know that this bullet is 25 grams. And remember, the first thing we need to do is convert that mass to kilograms, because that's the unit we need for momentum. So we'll start with our 25 grams. And we know we need to go to kilograms. So when we go to kilograms, we want to cancel out grams, and we'll put kilograms up top. Then recall, there are 1,000 grams in 1 kilogram. So basically, the math we're actually doing here is 25 grams divided by 1,000 grams. And that's going to get rid of their grams there. Okay, so when we do that division, we'll get 0.025 kilograms. That's the mass. So we've just solved for the mass of the bullet in kilograms. And now we're ready to go ahead and calculate momentum. Momentum, remember, is just equal to m times v. So we know momentum is m times v. And we actually already have all of the things we need to just calculate it. So we'll plug in the mass, 0.025, and we'll multiply that by the velocity, which is 2600 meters per second. When we multiply those two things together, we'll get 65. And actually, here is one unique place where the rounding is already done. Our calculator spits out 65. We just need two sig figs here because this has 1 2 sig figs and this has 1 2 sig figs, and we have 2 sig figs, so we're good. The last thing to think about is the units. Remember that momentum has the units of just basically cramming together the mass and the velocity. So the mass has units of kilograms, and the velocity has units of meters per second. And we cram those together, we get the units for momentum. So the momentum of this bullet then is 65 kilograms meters per second. Now let's review the properties of momentum. One thing you need to remember about momentum is that momentum is a vector. That means basically it has a direction. So momentum points in the direction of motion. So here we have a comet flying through space, and its momentum is going to be in the direction of motion, which that tail makes very easy to visualize. Next up, and maybe even more important, is that momentum is conserved. This is going to be the basis for tons of problems we'll solve later in this unit. That means that momentum is not created, and that momentum is not destroyed. For example, at the start of the pool game, we have the break, where the white cue ball is launched at the collection of pool balls. And we know the more momentum we give that white cue ball, the more momentum those balls will be able to have when they break. This is conservation of momentum in action. Now, we'll spend more time in later videos thinking about this important property. But for now, just remember, momentum is conserved. Okay, it's your turn now to calculate momentum. Calculate the momentum of a 165 gram cue ball moving at 8.9 meters per second. If you feel unsure of how to begin, go ahead and rewatch the calculation we just did. It's very similar. And then come back here. Okay, let's take a look at the full solution. We followed two steps, once again, converting mass to kilograms, where we got 0.165 kilograms for the mass of our cue ball. And then we calculated momentum by multiplying mass times velocity, and we get that P, which is our weird variable for momentum, is 1.5 kilograms meters per second. If you didn't get that, go ahead and pause the video and look through each step and find your mistake, and then try again. I know you can get this. It may take some practice. Let's review what we've learned. First, we explained momentum. We came to understand that momentum is the tendency of an object to stay in motion. Then we learned to calculate momentum, where we saw if we multiply mass in kilograms times velocity in meters per second, we actually get momentum. And lastly, we learned about the properties of momentum, namely that it's a vector and that momentum is conserved. Hey, hey.